What is something you enjoyed as a kid, but hate as an adult? Thinking about the future. When I was a kid, I imagined in the future, I'd be rich and do crazy science stuff like turning the sky green. I thought I'd have a cool job and sports cars and a mansion in Beverly Hills. Thanks, Weezer. Now when I think about the future, I wonder what the hell to do if I lose my job. About my parents getting old and to a lesser degree. Will I have enough saved to live off in retirement? There's a quote by Marina Keegan that just breaks my heart. I miss dreaming forwards, Anna said. What? Quote. I dream backwards now. You won't believe how backwards you'll dream someday. Never understood what she meant when I was a kid. Now that I understand, I wish I didn't. Sometime during college I stopped making new friends. Now all of my friends are the ones from high school I can reminisce with. Getting older. Christmas. As a kid it was time off school. Presents. And seeing my family. As an adult I'm lucky if I get both days off. I stress about finding the right gift for everyone. And I have to see my family. Staying home on a sick day. As a kid it was a huge victory. Got to stay in bed all day. Watch TV. And having a parent tend to your every need. Then as an adult you're just thinking about the work you're gonna have to make up for and how you hope you don't need to go to a doctor. Vienna sausages. My brother and I used to wrestle and fight over who would get the last can. Hadn't had them in ages and was telling my kid about them. So I thought I'd get a can for old time's sake. Could not even choke them down. They are so gross to me now. Are you me? I used to love them. Boasted them to my kid and bought a can. Ew. Even my son didn't like them and he'll eat anything. Gave them to my dog and no lie. She threw them up. Lol. I feel like sadness. I touched a core happy memory and fucked it up? Right. I was like, oh. I can pass on a happy memory to my kid and he just remembers it as the day I attempted to deploy a food weapon at him by having him try one. Maybe they changed the recipe. Moving house. I loved packing, choosing a new room, exploring a new neighborhood. I'd moved 20 times by the time I turned 18. I'm moving out of my first flat now. And it is the worst. Mom never warned me about the billion calls and contracts and credit scores in references and moving companies and just the general stress of moving out. I hate it. It's the worst. 20 times. Why? Mom had to move a lot because of her job. Mix that in with the fact she gets antsy and wants to move every 6 months and the number just kept going up. I've stayed in my current flat for 2 years and that's the longest I've ever stayed in one place. Going outside during the summer. Fuck the heat. Fuck bugs. Fuck humidity. Fuck bugs. Fuck hot ass wind. Fuck bugs. Fuck direct skin burning sunlight with hot ass wind. And fuck bugs. Summer in general. I loved it as a kid because it meant no school. Now it just means sweaty swamp ass 24/7. Ravioli in a can. Don't get me wrong, I love ravioli, just not canned. Staying up all night. As a kid, it was a badge of honor staying up all night long. Going to bed after the sunrise. Now means that I've worked too much. Sleeping really late as well. As an adult, sleeping late makes me feel like I've wasted a whole day off. My dad added, thanks for the gold! Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. My mom. The whole family. Swimming. I hate it now. Kids splashing you in the face and asking you throw them in the water and climbing on you like a jungle gymnast. You're it's way more fun to be the kid in the pool than the parent. My kids are now old enough I can sit on the side and watch, it is great. I remember being the kid and wondering why all the adults never wanted to get in the pool, haha. I wondered how it wasn't fun for them. All they had to do was make it fun and boom. It's fun. I remember thinking how it seemed like adults chose to not have fun. Travel. As a kid it was all vacation, as an adult it's almost all work. Weird. I find self-directed travel to be incredibly relaxing and carefree. Are you managing a large traveling family or something? Not up. but I loved camping as a kid. Now I take my family, and it's a chore hauling the camper and making sure it leveled off, doing all the maintenance work, etc. But my kid loves it, so it's worth it in the end. Making out with 14-year-olds. Yes, this post officer. How? He says he hates it. Yeah, but how does he know he hates it if he hasn't tried it recently? Oh, running. I used to race my brother everywhere, just for fun. Now, I'm definitely not running for that bus I could easily catch. I'd rather sit around and wait 30 to 120 minutes for the next one. I'm the opposite. I was the chubby kid at school, so hated running. I'd always finish last. As a cliche fat kid, I grew up to eat healthy and exercise regularly, running being one of my go-to faves. I'm mid-30s now, and whilst I'm no model, I'm lean and healthy. Certain 80s sitcoms tried watching the original Full House again and just couldn't get past 10 minutes of it. Pretty much anything with a laugh track is really hard for me to watch now. Living, spinning in a circle until I'm so dizzy I fall down. Super fun as a child. Great way to feel terrible and possibly get a concussion now. Snow. Yeah, since I've become an adult, I require something stronger like meth. Adults online who were really into me. Especially the ones who sent pics in Speedos. Yoo-hoo, I drank it all the time, but I couldn't imagine having a glass of that right now. Oh man, I haven't had Yoo-hoo since I was maybe 10. As a kid, I drank it while eating hot dogs and pretzels, which in hindsight is disgusting. Finding bugs in my house. The outside wall of my childhood bedroom had a Boston ivy growing over it. Beautiful in certain seasons. One thing I particularly loved about it was how it would often grow up through the floor in the inside behind my dresser. Now when I think about if that happened to my own house, I feel sick. The idea of being an adult, lol. I think just about every cereal and snack food I loved as a kid would taste excessively sugary to me now. I enjoyed life as a kid. Not a worry in the world. Now as an adult, the stresses of life have me stressed. Having no job, ketchup, delicious with a grilled cheese sandwich, getting out of the house. What a time to be alive right now, eh? Roller coasters. While I never liked the big ones, I like the small ones okay. But being almost 40 and riding them makes me feel like I might die afterwards. Around age 30, they suddenly made me nauseous. I enjoy them, but feeling pukey for the rest of the day isn't worth it. Sadly, the holiday season, I now see why my parents seemed exasperated when I complained when decorations weren't up post-Thanksgiving, or why they seemed so much more stressed than I ever even considered being. School would end. I would get to chill and it was the holidays and was so magical. Now I get it, with a job that doesn't stop for the holidays. It sneaks up on you and you barely get time as an adult to process all the activities before it's like December 23rd and it's all flown by. I could never seem to find time to do my Christmas shopping or decorating. The holidays completely stress me out now, and as a kid I thought it was the best time of the year. Jumping down 3 to 4 steps at a time. My knees won't put up with that nonsense now. Getting hair in new places. And my balls dropping. I also hate your balls dropping. I want my $20 back. Lunchables. I always told my parents to get me some after seeing the commercials. Looking at it now, who TF actually thinks this is a decent lunch? It's an overpriced box of cheese and crackers and a Capri Sun. My dad once came home with a brick of cheese, a container of deli ham, and a box of Ritz and told me I could make my own damn Lunchables. Tears of joy. Marshmallows. Cotton candy. Asterisk blech. Asterisk. Star Wars. Query, do you mean you hate the movies you once loved, or you hate what it's become? The new trilogy was supposed to bring balance to the Skywalker saga, not leave it in darkness. Emphatic response from my point of view, the sequels are evil. HK47, incredulous response, what would give you that impression, meatbag? Then you really are low. Oh wait, no, you're totally right, they're evil. Going to the mall. I used to like browsing stores, but now I just want to get what I need and go. I'm not an adult, but I could be on the swings for hours when I was younger. Now I can barely be there 30 seconds. Do they make adult-sized swings so that the legs don't reach the ground? Not off, but yes. They actually make really cool ones where there's an adult swing seat facing a much higher up toddler bucket seat. Honestly, I've grown to hate gaming. I've been a gamer all my life and own every major console since the NES. If you'd have told me a decade ago that I would have a period of 3 months plus out of work, I'd have told you I'd spend that time gaming. However, I just haven't. I've come to realize that any love I had for it has been killed off by games as a service or games designed simply to promote an in-game store. Anyone in their mid-late 20s onwards will remember a time where classic games were coming out year after year and each console delivered masterpieces of all genres. Then publishers and developers like EA, Ubisoft, Rockstar, Activision, etc., realized there was billions to be made repackaging the same old game or extending the lifespan of one game far beyond its means. I'm tired of it. I'm so fed up waiting for years between truly unique, creative, generation-defining games. Sony and Nintendo kept my interest these last 7 years. But I saw series after series die out to greed and be replaced by lootbox-driven disasters and free games with expensive skins. I started to wane and realized I no longer play games because I enjoyed them, but because I had done so for as long as could remember. I was almost duty-bound to. What little interest I had in PS5 died the second I saw GTA 5 announced. That was it. I realized at that point that I now hated what gaming had become. I unplugged my systems and put them in the loft. I'll give it a few months and pull out my retro consoles and see if my hatred is long-term, monsieur. There are still great games out there. I admit it feels like they are getting few and far between. When I read your post, my immediate thought was to suggest you pull out your NES and play some Blackthorn or 1942. That said, have you tried Subnautica? Great game, highly recommend it. I myself recently demothballed my GameCube, PS2 and N64. Good times, it all still seems to work. I loved Subnautica. It was a highlight in my past few years of gaming. The indies have been a great source of creativity and traditionalism this last decade, along with Sony and Nintendo exclusives. But I just see the way things are heading in terms of the mainstream, and can't believe that we're going to get another generation of the same, but with faster loading times and upscaled graphics. I think I just need a break. I get so invested with the promise of the new that I lose sight of the old at times. There's a treasure trove of wonderful games from the past 30 plus years that would take a lifetime to play. So whilst I don't like the direction gaming is going in, I can always enjoy what came before. This is why I mainly play my retro consoles and stay away from the newer stuff. Unless something new really catches my eye, which isn't all that often. There's many older games I never played that could re-spark my love for gaming. I also enjoy VR quite a bit and it's still evolving to be even better. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.